The brush pen is something I've had a lot of fun with ever since I discovered them many, many years ago. And for those of you who like to tinker and like to try new things with a single pen, this system of pen, this feeding system, air ink interchange, it can be utilized with a wide array of different materials, from sponges that you could get at your local store to nylon brushes of varying fineness. Noodler's isn't offering any animal products because of how they're farmed. I'm not a member of PETA or anything. I just don't. I've witnessed some of the films, and I just don't want to be involved in that. But I would never tell anyone not to use animal hair if that's what their preference is. This method will work with I believe the largest array of different fibers that has been utilized in a brush pen. It's if you want to test what fiber will work, soak it in ink a little while, see if it changes its properties, changes its behavior, and you'll soon find out whether it's a suitable candidate. This strange instrument is basically a Triumph nib. Pushed on over an O-ring. This O-ring you'll find to be very useful. Your retailer, the Noodler's distributor, anyone with Noodler's pens, this is a section seal O-ring on the Noodler's AHAP. That O-ring is very useful in various types of brush applications with this pen. It's sold separately. I haven't been able to find an O-ring like that at a hardware store readily, and those that did have it were overcharging. So I'm hoping people can bear with me. I'm trying to make sure as many Noodler's retailers have these as possible. But with the Triumph nib, if you fold over or cut short the brush, and you slide it, the O-ring, two spaces down, and you get the threads. This is from a snorkel or a TM, late 50s production. And the O-ring goes on slightly crooked, and you can get it to do this. Lean against the brush, or you have folded the brush under the O-ring. The O-ring's only purpose is to hold the nib in place over the brush, and the brush is acting as a feeder under the nib here. The only reason I bring this up is there have been collectors over the years who've said that the Triumph nib is completely useless and can't be jerry-rigged onto another pen. And if you're watching this, wherever and whoever you are that believe that, this is finally a pen where the Triumph nib can actually be jerry-rigged to fit and to operate. Now, in the instructions, basically, with a Noodler supplied brush, this is fine nylon. It will show you how to divide it into thirds. When it's divided into thirds, you'll be able to put one of the thirds into the ebonite, like this. Or, if you don't divide it into thirds, you can use it whole. This one has been used for quite a while. This little spring goes over the same O-ring seen in the Ahab. That this section O-ring goes over the brush, and the metal retainer spring goes over the O-ring. The pointed part goes into the center of the brush, and the hook goes over the O-ring. And the reason for that is if it were under the O-ring and you just left the O-ring as is, there would be no air-ink interchange. And this assembly, which I'll show you here, if it focuses on it, literally like this. Now I know if you're an artist and you like different brush tips, this was disassembled. This is restored the same way all the other Conrads are restored. Just these two O-rings and some silicone grease. And you basically need a paper clip. A paper clip will help. Should be firmly tightened. Not so much that you grind it in there, but firm enough that when you turn the mechanism, goes back and forth without turning the main part of the mechanism. Now this is Noodler's Firefly ink. It's been on the market a while. Many years. This is it's a highlighting ink, and if you do a lot of highlighting, I know many of you have asked me the highlighter pen that's been included with Year of the Golden Pig, the felt can wear out. And I have the distinct impression that replacing the felt with the official tip is not inexpensive. Certainly not as long-lasting and as versatile as this brush. So, I've been working on this for a while, and it's my hope that the ability to easily, as I just showed you, replace the brushes and be able to utilize very wide lines as well as fine lines all in the same pen with ease and with wetness. It doesn't hesitate to draw ink. I hope that will assist all of you who have a need for highlighting. In addition, This method writes very well. With black. And it's incredibly fluid, it's incredibly smooth, and it's just really a joy to be able to utilize ink in the classic way. This is, it's like a 2,000-year-old nib brought to life in an affordable fashion with great versatility. The ability to make both this very broad, very wide, traditional tip in the same pen with an extremely fine tip. What was the main goal? This is a Whaleman's sepia. I suppose a profoundly unpolitically correct ink. But it's an ink that loves the brush. Minjiro Nakahama. This, it dries a different color. I don't know if the camera caught that or if the software showed it. But you'll see it darkens very quickly as it dries, becomes that sepia color. And this is the ink that the story of Japan is behind it. And the brush pen really, the brush pen was available at the time this ink came out, but it wasn't as close to perfection as I wanted it to be. There was a little, it didn't have sufficient versatility, and this model, this method has significantly more versatility, many, many more possibilities in both the fine and the broad spectrum that simply weren't available and hadn't been developed yet before. I've never liked that artists, especially at the university level who already have college debt, are buying a whole set of brush points and brushes, disposable and otherwise, and I've always believed that it's more than possible to simplify that and to put it into a single unit that has many versatile points, or points, even if you need a different filament, many different, the coarseness of hair, its different flow rates, all of what the fineness of brush calligraphy involves, to concentrate that into a single pen has been an overriding goal of this project. The reason these are kept out. This prototype was made, and it was found that this end piece is marvelous in its ability to center a brush. If you need the larger, wetter brush to be fine and centered, and you need it to do this and force the fibers into a central point, then this little part, this is included with every Year of the Golden Pig, with every Blue Ghost, any fluorescent reflecting ink that Noodler sells has this free black light in the box in the 4.5 ounce size. And this end piece comes off quite easily. Now, not all of them will fit like this. But if you don't get it to fit exactly like this, there have been a few people who try to put it on. It should generally friction fit with a little bit of tinkering. Or using a little bit of sandpaper on the edge can get it to have some tackiness with the with the edge. Or if all else fails and you absolutely need the guide to force the tip as it's being used to go back to a central point, you can always put a tiny drop of adhesive at the base of this part. But generally, it can be friction fit. And that's just a tip for the artist out there, in case these are also fairly inexpensive if you want to get them on the side, away from a bottle of ink. If you absolutely need the point to be maintained with different fibers as a central tip. It isn't always necessary to have to pay for a proprietary tip. Now, this is just an ordinary paper clip. And it's a tool that you might find helpful. With pliers or tweezers, simply bend the end . Make sure it fits. You only want to bend it slightly, say about a millimeter and a half on the end. And then look down for the ring. Now, the hook has two uses. One of the uses you saw earlier is to hold the O-ring and to allow the air ink interchange with the larger brush size. The other use is generally to pull out the third section of one of these sections, to pull it out when it's worn out and when you need it to be replaced. The spring itself pushes the brush into place, holds it into place. Now, on some fibers, this is the one included with the pen and sold as a replacement. But some fibers you might find at a Home Depot, Lowe's, Ace Hardware, AC Moore, your local art supply store, they will require just a dip in soapy water in case there are oils on them. You don't want them to hinder the flow, and they might require a piece of string to hold them into place. Once it's wet, make it pointed. Put the hook in front of the base of the brush. Pull the front in and forward. And push down using this paperclip end the spring until it rests at the base of the brush. Now, because this was just set in fairly firmly and tightly, it's going to be a dry line. If you don't want it to be a dry line and you want it to be fairly wet, but you don't want it to overdo it and to have a wet line, a too wet a line, I should say. You can make an air channel. Well, this technically would be an ink channel. You push the brush in until it will accept a very thin pin. And one just the thin pin, that's all it needs. And that will provide some looseness, some space between the fibers that will permit greater flow to the tip. If it's too much flow, begin to pull it out a little bit, and the cone inside the ebonite will gradually tighten up and reduce that flow. Now you notice this is threaded, if the camera captures it. And there are four holes. Now these are the air ink exchange holes that enable this piece of ebonite to use virtually any fiber you put into it, and even a piece of sponge. It makes it incredibly versatile. The capillary action of the ebonite will adapt readily to innumerable delivery fibers. Move it counterclockwise until you feel the threads click. Once you know that it's in the threads, thread it forward. If you're using a fiber you're unfamiliar with, or that it's the first time and you've managed to get it to behave and follow the cone, and you've got the right width, if it's too much. If you have a big set of fibers like a shock of wheat, you can overwhelm the ebonite. So through trial and error with a different type of fiber, you should be able to get it down to look basically like this. And to be from the section rim to the tip about 2.2 centimeters. And that's approximately, if you go a bit beyond that, the tip will begin to bend inside the cap. And after you've put the effort in to get the tip you want, whether it's a fan or it's a point, whatever you wanted, you don't want it ruined by pushing it into the tip. So adjust your fibers according to that measurement, knowing that you want it to stop at that 2.2, that approximately 2.2 distance between this edge and the end of the cap. In the initial group of these pens, the tortoise shell are adjusted and cut as highlighting tips, and the black are as writing tips. Now, if you're very skilled with Chinese calligraphy, you can hold your hand in such a way that the last two fibers are the only ones that touch the page. I have a great deal of difficulty doing it because I write with a heavy hand. And well, you can see the fineness at the edges of the lines. It's very difficult to keep it just touching those last two fibers. Barely got it here. But once you can, it's an amazingly fine line. And flexibly, an amazingly broad line. That's over a centimeter wide. From a hair to a centimeter. It's very versatile. I've always felt these are worthwhile. And with a single non-disposable pen that you can restore the filler seals, you can use different fibers. If you can't find other fibers or don't want to use other fibers and you simply want a conventional nylon brush, they'll be available with your Noodler's retailer. And you can have the broad, extremely broad selection. If you want to adjust it to be pinpoint on a very deep, broad brush, it's possible to do so at minimal cost, all on the same pen. And with the feed that's included, there's a great deal of versatility. All of this disassembles, the method by which the brush is held in place, you can adapt it to many different types. The last type I would like to demonstrate, it might be considered extreme to do so. If you need to expel a brush, use the other end of the paper clip. If this is too wide, don't force it through. You'll crack the ebonite, and the ebonite is, well, don't lose this and don't lose the feed because there aren't spares at the moment, and I do not know when they'll become available. It's handmade, and It's lucky that we even have some of these available for the holiday season. Don't know when more will become available. But I'm trying. Don't use too much sponge. You just want a little bit. I've made the mistake twice of taking a piece this long, thinking it'll slide all the way up. This type of synthetic sponge, it's only a much smaller piece that you need. Once you get it out the end, trim off the excess. If it's in there tightly, you don't need the spring with this application. It should be noted that when you've changed the point to a completely new feeder system, either establish capillary action by refilling with ink or by putting some mildly soapy water, dish soap detergent, one drop in a fluid ounce would be enough. But you need to establish the capillary flow. If you don't, there'll be an air pocket that'll just sit there, and the ebonite hasn't, without establishing the capillary flow, the ink is not flowing. You don't have an air ink interchange continuum yet, and it'll result in it not functioning. But once the ink is in the ebonite feed and it's being replaced by air as it's being used up, you'll have a line even out of this piece of kitchen sponge. The ebonite feed will do the work. All the different fibers, even a sponge, this feed will enable you to use those as different writing implements, all out of the same pen. And, well, you'll never get fine or line variation out of this. It'll just write the same way all the time, sort of like a marker. But and this feed will also feed a marker felt. I've successfully put that in this feed as well. Provided you do not obstruct the air vents that are in the ebonite feed, it'll be able to feed whatever you happen to put into it, provided it can deal with ink. I hope you have fun with it. I know some of you out there, that you want something in a little bubble dome that writes with one color ink all the time, and when it runs out, you throw it out. Well, I'm not going to be making anything like that. It's not environmentalism to be frugal. It's just being frugal and not liking waste. That I like the design whereby it is all replaceable and can be maintained for long periods of time. And this design, when the seal wears out, Home Depot, 65 cents. Some of the Noodler's retailers are less than that, although sometimes Home Depot is above a dollar, so that this varies. This is a faucet seal, and it fits the filler of this pen, and it's pennies for brush replacements and pennies for other fibers. It shouldn't be $15 and $18 and $5 for a disposable that only lasts one single filling, and a piston fill unit with a replaceable brush. The brush is some exotic sounding name, and it's upwards of $26. It should be pennies, and I don't really care if somebody is a rich artist or a poor artist. What you're trying to do is the expression upon the page with ink, and it's my hope that none of that matters, and that you might actually appreciate the versatility and the frugality than the practicality of this offering. And that's not everything I know about this pen, or everything I know that can be done with it, but I hope it gives you enough of a hint to experiment further and have fun with it. And hopefully you haven't tuned out by now because the YouTube video is too long. Thanks for watching.